You make your fantasy picks for NASCAR yet?
Yeah, but I'm still not. I'm still iffy about I have Logano in.
Yeah, I don't got Logano. I know I got Briscoe this week as one. Briscoe always runs good at Phoenix for some reason. Miami Beach as we are set for football at Hard Rock Stadium. I think I even took Hosovar this week. Fucking, I've been getting screwed. I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna fucking do something different. I think I even took Hosovar. As it'll be the Tennessee Titans taking on the Miami Dolphins. The first of two on this December Monday night, the Titans and the Dolphins underway from South Florida.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up. You talk about this Titan defense. Now, they've been dreadful against the run. No getting around at number 32, dead last in the NFL.
Stopping the run, that's been an issue for them all season long. Aren't you glad that you're not coaching the defense right now?
I'm very glad. They said that they've seen it in doses, but very, very small doses.
Yeah, you've got to be consistent. It's down in and down out, being able to play it, understand what you have to get done, and finally stop some people, put them on the ground.
60 catches for him now on the year. This last one, a first down. Inside handoff to Mixon. That strong running there as he's across midfield.
That's the best run I've had.
As soon as you fucking went to the up the right side of the counter, I knew I can knew it was wide open. I had the fucking cornerback coming on a blitz.
They block well too.
Not only have they scouted the line of scrimmage, with their agility, they can get upfield and hit moving targets like linebackers, defensive backs. They do a really good job helping out the running game.
Pass the 20. It's a big play there for Miami. 41 yards.
Already over 1,000 yards receiving this season. That catch is just going to add to his total. Certainly not resting on his laurels. He's trying to continue to gain as many yards as possible and continue this big season.
They'll give it to Mixon.
I'm stuck.
It worked out for him getting stuck. Motherfucker.
His 26th touchdown.
My team's not the greatest, but I'm going to give her a go.
My team is decent, but you know, I've been struggling.
I'm going to fucking play my heart out, though. Lucky.
And it's now a 7-0 game. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown.
I got it right now. Fucking JD's got fucking more wins than me right now.
This fielded right at the goal line. And his guys will get the football right.
What's his record?
5-8 or something like that. I think he's got 5. Well, I know I only got 3.
Tannehill and the Titans come up now, 1st and 10.
I like to play a lot of man defense, but I don't got the fucking players to fucking play man defense.
And he's gonna get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, said he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue? Just make sure you feed me.
And it's a fumble.
Oh, motherfucker.
And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. Always costly to call. Defenders, they become so adept, though, at jarring it free.
Yeah, it's amazing that there aren't more fumbles caused, because now, if you're an offensive player, you go through ball security drills every single day. It's really not out of line to think that you should take the ball to bed with you and just hold on.
That fucker keeps falling forward.
The line is, no matter how much you try to protect it, these guys
usually
it
don't work out for
me. To knock it out.
A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be 2nd down. Once again, they run with Mixon. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup, and that's all they needed to move the sticks. Now a play fake. Rodgers. And his throw.
Oh, what the hell is that?
The Dolphins at 500 hit 6 and 6.
Hey, do you want to grab me a Gatorade? My sugar's a little low.
Trying to turn things around here in this
Gatorade.
It always helps to have a home crowd behind you, giving you encouragement.
Grab me a Gatorade.
You give them something good to cheer about. So you know they just want to come out and play well for their
Oh my. Hold the ball.
And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down. One thing that you're going to see from this offense is that they love the matchup with their wide receivers against this secondary. That one wasn't successful, but don't expect them to back away from attacking all game long. Buying time to his left.
That's picked.
And
dropped it.
Broken up.
Dropped it again.
Contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
Fucking Waddle.
So on fourth down, Dolphin kicker Jason Sanders comes on. The kick by Sanders is good, and the Dolphins will add on to their lead. So the defense will force the first turnover of the game, and then they add on to that by getting the field goal.
And you don't just want to take the ball away from your opponent, partner. You want to make them hurt as well. And if you don't score yourself on defense, turn it over to your offense and have them put points on the board.
The return man, Chris Moore. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go.
Who you got running back?
Look to get
Jamar Gibbs.
Down 10-0 early as they've got it first and 10. Here's a throw, complete right side.
I thought he was going to fumble that for a minute when he got hit.
Result, only 4 yards there on the play. And that'll make it second down. You talk about this Miami defense. They've been excellent against the pass, the number 6 unit in the NFL.
And I'm struggling a little bit trying to really categorize this crew. They're top 10 in the league against
the
pass, but the bottom half of the league in sacking the quarterback. That doesn't make sense. Imagine if this group ever put pressure on the QB, it'd easily move into the top 5.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Now Tannehill with a little touch pass to his wideout. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
Here's Hill on the return.
Damn.
54 yards on the punt, 12 on the
return. If he would have got by that one guy there, he fucking had all kinds of room.
I was hoping the guy would have run past me.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And they are back down to 500 following the loss last week. Consistency has been a real issue for them. So
motherfucker.
Far.
It was wide open.
Going to show up every week. I mean, there's no consistency with this ball club.
What the fuck?
I know it frustrates the coaching staff, and it also has to frustrate the key leaders in the locker room. They got to figure out how to get coordinated.
They fake the give. Now Rodgers.
That was funny. That was funny as fuck. You had two guys there.
Ends up throwing an incompletion, and I think he'll take that.
Second and 10. Mixing up the middle. 41 yards rushing for him now to this point. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
Throwing is Rodgers.
And
incomplete. They tried to drop it off, but he couldn't hold on.
It's pretty early in the game, but they've already tried to establish him not just as a runner, but as a receiver as well. Didn't happen there, but I wouldn't be surprised at all to see them try again shortly.
Sanders kick is good. I need to get some offense going here.
He might be being set up here for a busy ball game already. Two kicks here in the first quarter, and he's knocked both through the posts.
And for now, you know they'll be happy getting those 3 points, but what they really want is to find a way for him to kick extra points instead of field goals.
And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Titans offense set to begin the drive. They're still in search of an initial first down as they come up here first and 10. Tannehill's throw complete there to Rice. And that's good for a gain of 6, and that's going to bring up second down. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle.
Oh, no, this is stuff I can't stop right here.
Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
And good running there as he'll take this all the way up to midfield. 17 yards on that play for the Titans.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
From the 50, it's Tannehill.
Oh, shit. I didn't see the second safety. I seen the fucking cornerback playing off. And as soon as I threw it, I knew it was catch. Fuck. I wasn't watching the safety. I fucking like, oh fuck, he's fucking playing off. Motherfucker.
I don't know who that was there.
And man, they seem to be clicking on all three phases right there. The defense doing its part for the pick six.
Okay, I gotta smarten up here.
It's absolutely been the definition of a start that you would pick for yourself and for your team, right? And I have a feeling that they just want to stay in this zone. What's truly incredible about this start is they can add on a couple more scores. This one could legitimately be over in the second quarter.
And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. They find themselves in a good size hole here, and a good size hole early on in this game as they come up on first down. Meanwhile, Tannehill's that's taken in by Okonkwo. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days.
That's going to be bad if he got outside.
You can run wide receiver routes with him. You can make him a primary target, and that's how he'll shred the defense.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Another run for Gibbs here, and he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
From just shy of midfield, here's second and 6. Now it's Tannehill off the bootleg. Got an open man to the right. That's Wesco. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then of course they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, and that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
Jalen Phillips, the edge man on the tackle.
Good solid gain on first down, about what you'd expect from the big guy carrying the ball.
Second down and 6 now.
I'll go back to you.
Tannehill. Throw left side, completion to Rice. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of five. This will be play number seven on the drive. Third and a yard. And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And he's got the
first. Oh, it's coming back.
Bring him down at the 28-yard line. We are in for a good one as we're through one on EA Sports. Second quarter now. Titans in possession of the football. The first down line at the 34 here on third down. Tannehill.
Damn it.
Short throw taken in by Okonkwo. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 29-yard line. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
Oh, I was right there and I missed it.
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of nine on first down. Second down and a little more than a yard here. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and we'll still get the first down. They love being physical.
On first and 10, Tannehill. It's complete to Williams. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Here's Tannehill. And now he lost the
motherfucker.
Tannehill loses it. And this is
talking bullshit.
And a big turnover.
Everyone was covered, but fuck me.
Well, give some credit to
two
the
fucking fumbles.
They forced the big play, knocked the ball free from him, but it's a cardinal sin by the quarterback. Know where you are on the field, and he just gave up at a minimum 3 points.
Instead of getting down, takes the contact, the turnover ensues. 48 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame. From the 21, here's second and three. Again, it's Mixon. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 18 big yards on that one, and a Miami first.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because he is just shredding them at this
Damn
point.
It.
And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
Here's second and 10. On play action, Rodgers.
Oh, he got the block, motherfucker.
That was a fumble. Yep.
Football. It's picked up by the Titans. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. A disappointing end of the sequence there. He was starting to turn nothing into something, and then he lost the football.
And sometimes things get lost in the transition. And what I mean by that is you go from being a passer to a runner. And at a certain point, once you cross the line of scrimmage, you're strictly a runner now. There's no more downfield threat. Make sure you take care of the football while you're traversing downfield.
17 yards on that play for the Titans.
A big hole there. How about him handling the point of attack? Just positioning himself so that run could go right off of his backside and deep into the secondary.
On first down, it's Tannehill.
Oh, fuck. I didn't even see it. Fucking.
Sacked back at the 31. It'll be a loss of 10. And it'll bring up second. This offense continues to shoot themselves in the foot. And here, another sack.
All game long, we've seen missed assignments, which have led to turnovers, sacks. This group has not played well at all here in the first half.
And they only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
In motion left is Rice. They'll go with a touch pass here, trying to pick it up. And a great read by the secondary. They come up to stop that touch pass before it can even get back to the line. Kick is absolutely perfect, and that will move the deficit from 20 down to 17. We're trailing here in the first half still, but maybe, Charles, that'll help them get some momentum back. First the forced fumble, and then they're able to get a field goal out of it.
And down in the game, they came out and created their own opportunity on one side of the ball and did get points out of it, as you mentioned. Complimentary football right there as they try to bring this one back to even.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive? A little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown, but they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punching the end zone without turning it over.
On play action, it's Rodgers. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far. But on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Escaping the pressure right. I had a man open, but he missed him, and it's incomplete.
Why does
one first down
do
here, and that's all,
damn,
folks.
God.
Good work by
guys,
this
wide open.
To hold things in check and force a punting situation.
And the punter Bailey on now as he sends this one away. Chris Moore returning it. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Titans will be backed up deep to begin the drive as they take over first and 10. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. Down throw, Tannehill.
What fucking throw is that, Tannehill, you fucking pole smoker?
He's in charge of the ball, dude. The throw wasn't even close. That was a quarterback's fault, the fucking legend. The throw wasn't even close.
Incomplete.
offense on third down tonight. Just one for three thus far. This is third and 10. Throwing again is Tannehill. Setting up the screen, this is Gibbs. And they'll get him down 2 yards shy after a pickup of 8. Fourth and 2.
And that's a play that's not uncommon on third and long because the offense is just hoping that somehow they can get a guy in space and follow some blockers downfield. Does a pretty nice job there getting a few yards, but he ends up getting stuck.
That fucking punt fucking sucked. Or maybe it was the wind.
And taken just outside the 40-yard line.
Isn't the wind like 8 miles an hour?
I don't know what it is. I know it was going against it, but I don't know what it is.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Obviously not the intended goal last drive. They had to punt the football, but still they've got the lead here and now a chance to add on to that lead if they can get points on this drive. First and 10 upcoming. Danico Autry is in on the stop.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse.
They said that fucker keeps falling forward.
76 yards for him on the ground so far tonight as he has been terrific in this first half. They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And great blocking downfield as he's got this almost to the 35-yard line. That one good for 13 and a Dolphin first down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Now they'll throw with Rodgers. This goes out wide for Mixon. And he
roughing the passer.
Bounds after a nice pickup. And that will also lead us to the two-minute warning. So roughing the passer penalty and an automatic first down.
And that's the mark of a bad team, partner, because that's an easily preventable penalty, but they just didn't take the proper steps to make it so.
Touchdown, Dolphins! Joe Mixon with career touchdown number 75. And the Dolphins are able to add on to their first half lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And a rout is on here in this first half. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. They trail here by 24 points. Got to get going soon, you'd have to think, as they come up first and 10.
Oh, what the fuck?
Another one intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey.
I wanted to throw it in the flat. He threw it upfield.
At least he set the offense up nicely.
What the fuck? He was wide open in the flat. And fucking threw it way up there.
He's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
Eluding the pressure right. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
Partner, this is almost an unwinnable spot for a defense. They have to come right out for a first and goal trying to stop him. But let me hold on a second. Let me take that back real quick. They can win here if they force a field goal try. Still a long ways away from that happening, but that has to be what they're thinking right now.
Call it a gain of a couple. The defense stiffening here. It's third and goal.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a third time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
Rolling to his right. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Oh, my God.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
Oh, that was a touchdown.
Jason Sanders now for the Miami field goal. Less than an extra point attempt here. This is an 18-yarder. Sanders' kick is good, and the Dolphins will add on to their lead. So the interception set him up with terrific field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. Oh, you've always wanted to end drives with points, but that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say we should have done better there.
And this will be a touchback as Ed sails over the end line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
And a pretty athletic run right there as he's going to get this down inside the 40. Now the offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted.
Is he about to get back up?
I
don't know. I thought he was fucking gonna fumble for a minute.
Knocked him for a loss.
After the run, Tannehill gonna throw. He's airing it out for Williams. And that's gonna be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Trying to get something positive to happen here before the break, and they sure need it. They went for the big one, but it winds up incomplete.
Now let's see, and the offense still out there. They elect to go on fourth and 11. They snap it to Tannehill. It's complete, swings it out to his running back. But they're going to wrap him up as he'll go down well short of a first. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Titans going to get the ball to start the second half, and they trail here as we get back to it on EA Sports. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. A CD, they certainly know the hole that they face as they begin the second half. They have to do what precious few teams have done in NFL history. That's try to come back from a four-possession deficit.
And partner, you know, as that team gathers, they're saying to each other, you never say never, right? Because if you're on an NFL roster, that's how you have to think. You can always come back and win a ball game. And let's face it, we saw a certain Super Bowl, a 25-point lead late that wasn't enough to put someone away. But that being said, this task is near impossible. Let's face it. And bottom line is, it officially becomes impossible if this possession is an empty one.
First and 10, here's Gibbs. Knifes his way forward here, but just 3 yards on the play. Second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end, complete. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
On the move pass.
Oh, what the hell? He's coming back.
There he goes. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do
fuck off.
So let's see what this is about.
Holy fuck.
Tap it quickly to their receiver, and he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. Across midfield and into Miami territory. They'll get a couple yards back, but not more than that. They'll be left with 12 yards to go on third down. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
And a throw there going to be incomplete.
And there's another stop. One of the league's best defenses is certainly bringing it again this week.
Here's Ryan Stonehouse now as he's on to punt for Tennessee.
Yeah, it's going to bounce backwards. No.
He was looking for the checkout bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. Now the first half definitely went their way, and this would seem to be a great opportunity to kind of put this game a little closer out of reach with a score here.
Yeah, and it's a wonderful opportunity.
Oh, they go walking it up.
Because if they can add 7 more to their lead before the other guys even see the football, that could be the decisive blow in this game. I think that's how they're eyeing it. That's how they're approaching it.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Back to Mixon on second down. Takes this to the 27. Give him 4 yards.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Dolphins first down.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. Meanwhile, Rodgers' throw here going to be caught by Wilson. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them, and these guys have been taking advantage so far.
Now here's a throw right side taken in by his tight end, and that's good for a pickup of 10 yards, and that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left. Well, that's always a good place to throw it just because he's one of the biggest targets not only on this team but in the National Football League.
And you and I both know the quarterbacks love these large body tight ends, and why not? Nowadays, they're really wide receivers who are just taller and have a little bit more weight. These guys catch the football, make big plays downfield. In the old days, we wanted them to block. Now coaches want them to catch the football first.
Roger. Rodgers throws taken in by Waddle. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans' 15-yard line. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward.
And if anyone thinks they're just going to tuck their horns in and pull back off the throttle a little bit, you can forget it. Even with this big third quarter lead, I think this team's going to continue to take their shots downfield, and there's another completion.
And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Only three there on the screen at second down.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
In motion, Hill. He's going to handle it on the touch pass.
Has a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
Play number nine set to come here on the drive on third and two. Out of the shotgun, they run with Mixon. And this is not going to be enough. Was in search of 2 yards and only got halfway there. So they decide not to back him up. They want the down. An interesting call there as it'll lead to fourth down. Jason Sanders now for the Miami field goal. This an easy one, 23-yarder. The kick by Sanders is good, and the Dolphins will add onto their lead. So tack on three more, though this, it's just a rare drive where they did not find the end zone.
Yeah, you're right about that, partner, but at this point, I don't think you're too concerned about that. You just want to possess the football for a while and drain the clock. If you can get three out of it, that's great, too.
And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. The Titans' offense set to begin the drive. Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail-biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people...
Oh, what's Rice doing there? That thing Washington should have been there. I guess Washington's tired or something.
...to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
Tannehill intercepted again. Picked up by Javon Holland. And the Dolphins are going to have great field position here as this is returned just shy of midfield.
I'm retiring after this game.
He's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season.
Don't do that. I'm joking. I'm just joking. Don't be like Deshaun.
Maybe for his own sake after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he throws.
Ball spotted at the 45. Here's a second and four. They'll stay on the ground. Mixon again. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41.
I'm surprised I'm even doing this game.
He's got a first down.
It's just mistakes costing me fucking penalties, fucking fumbles, interceptions. Fucking.
On play action. Now Rodgers.
That's a good block.
This will be caught. It's Waddle. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
Your running back can definitely block. There's been a couple of times I thought I was like going to get a sack and your fucking running back is throwing the block.
It's really been impressive. Scheme, design, execution.
Mixon with a first down carry. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out.
He was hurt last week.
Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and two. They'll run here with Raheem Mostert. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Raheem Mostert, his fifth rushing touchdown.
You trade A-Train away?
And the Dolphins,
yeah, I gave him the scooter.
That's how you got Mixon then, eh?
Yep.
Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. This taken in at the goal line. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But, Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this, no matter how the game looks on paper.
That was my fault.
This one has turned out to be.
I was trying to cut inside. I should have stayed outside.
They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough at run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading
the
right path to the ball carrier. Well, they certainly aren't letting up today, partner, because they've forced big turnovers already, and it's been incredibly tough for them to get yards against, let alone put points up on the board.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Back to throw, Tannehill. He's got it to Williams. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. 50 catches for him now on the year, and he's got a first down. One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back now in Miami. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. A throw over the middle taken in. So the completion good for 7 there. And that will bring up second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. A tackler almost on the spot, that means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
And that one opened up for him well as he'll take this down to the 26-yard line. That's a first down pickup for Tennessee on a gain of 10. Down right around the 25. Tackled that time by Jerome Baker out of Ohio State.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
From the 25, here's second and 9. Tannehill now to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete.
Oh, damn.
They get 7 there on the screen. It'll set up a third down.
He's had success running the football, and this is more or less an extension of that because they drop it off to him on the screen. And I'll bet he's thinking to himself, if I didn't have to slow up a bit here in traffic, I could have really made something out of that one.
Play number 9 set to come here on the drive on 3rd and 2. Another carry for the fullback, Ricard. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
I'll bet they thought they had picked that one up because it was a 3rd and 2 call, and they got awfully close. Now we're at 4th and inches. I wonder if they think they're feeling lucky here and maybe want to go pick it up.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. They'll try and run for it. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on 4th. They only needed about 4 or 5 inches there, relied on the big guys up front, and got it done.
Yeah, this is the time to just go ahead and hit it straight ahead. No juking, right? No movement in the backfield. Take the ball and go. As I heard a coach tell a player a long time ago, save your dancing for the club, son. Just get up into that line of scrimmage.
And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. Titans going to use the first of their timeouts.
Didn't like the looks of that.
That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. They'll try the air now with Tannehill.
Oh, I hit the wrong button.
For the fourth time tonight, it's an interception.
Oh, I'm fucked.
Picked off by Deshaun Elliott. And the Dolphins are going to take over at their own 2-yard line. But with this advantage, this defense knew the passes were coming, and they stayed in position, Charles, and picked one off here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, what a way to cap things off, huh? Because I think this is part of the game within the game. They see the scoreboard, they see what they can accomplish, and they went for it.
They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it second and six. So fourth quarter, a nice run there to start this drive. Charles, what do you think the split will be here between run and pass?
Well, partner, I think it'll lean towards the run, but this is also not a time where you just totally do that. You still have to possess the ball, move the sticks.
What time is the race start? 3:30 or something today? Oh, yeah, I think 3:30.
All right, Charles, help me out here. Fourth quarter, you've got the lead, and you run backwards into the end zone. You're just trying to do too much.
I almost don't have words for it, but you know every coach that we talk to talks about running backs or people running the football, running north-south, getting upfield. He went way in the opposite direction, and that's going to cost his team.
Yeah, it cost him big time. Still leading, but it costs him. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And you see a lot of frustrated faces as they are inching closer to a fourth straight loss. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive.
Lucky that wasn't picked.
And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Second down, here's Gibbs. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of three. And guess what? It brings up third down.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Throwing on third down, Tannehill. Short throw taken in by Okonkwo. And he will have a Titans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
Oh, my fullback missed that fucking block.
There on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
They suspected it was a power play up the middle coming at them, and boy, were they right. That defense got downhill in a hurry and limited them to just a couple on first down.
This is second and eight. They'll fake it. Now Tannehill. That ball caught. And now look at this. Big game.
Fuck off.
And this is picked up by the Dolphins. And I don't know that that fumble is going to matter a whole lot. You look at
another fucking fumble. Like, fucking suck a dick.
Yeah, not only scratching his head, but probably writing.
Not you, Tindle. Fuck my guys.
We're
fucking
this come practice next week.
Unreal. I'll go suck him for.
Doesn't matter at this point, but being sloppy.
Are you serious?
And this will be scooped up by the defense.
It's not exactly round and round we go. But I'm looking at the four defenses. Back to back possessions. The ball balls turned over.
Back-to-back plays.
I mean, just that quickly, and you think you're going to the bench to get a little break, and all of a sudden you're hearing sudden change. Get back out there, grabbing your helmets and running back out on the field. I don't think it's going to affect them much now, but if this keeps up, you're going to have two very angry defenses yelling at the offense to take care of the ball.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
Good strong run against the 3-4 set, and that 3-4, you've got to have your guys up front eat up a lot of blocks. The guy playing over the center, the nose, he usually has to take on double teams. But when you're able to successfully move him, you're often able to get some yardage. And that's when linebackers have to clean up and make tackles.
Inside handoff here to Ricard. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Well, not a lot of flash and dash on that play. Second and two, and they hand it to the big man, and he ends up picking up a first down. A little bit of gray area there, though, but I think what they thought, hey, we hand it to him here. If we come back and don't get it, we still got another down to try and pick it up.
Rice will go in motion left. And he'll get it here on the touch pass. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
And a lot of times, these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
Second and a couple. A shotgun snap for Tannehill. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
The Titans on third down. They've converted a third of their opportunities, 3 for 9. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Sliding out of the pocket. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. Nowhere to go downfield, but he's able to get out of bounds and stop the clock here with a first down.
It hasn't been the cleanest game for him, but there was a sign of improvement as he looks towards the next one. Nice bit of scrambling to move the sticks, and even more importantly, he didn't risk adding another interception to his ledger.
Now a give to Gibbs, running left. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8.
Oh, that's great.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
The throw on second down is Tannehill. Right side to Williams. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4.
I thought that wasn't a bad time to call the screen. I thought late game, down on the scoreboard, had to figure they were expecting a pass downfield.
Yeah, so the edge rushers, they're coming. That could have hit big. You're right. Good recognition defensively to snuff that one out.
Oh, he drops it, of course. He fucking drops it.
It just seems like all game long there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
Well, in the grand scheme of things, those 3 points likely not going to matter much, but I guess they get a little closer, a little more respectability.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been outplayed all game long, but like my mom used to tell me all the time before I went out, dress up a little bit, son. Make yourself respectable. And that's what they're doing here. They're just dressing up the final score.
And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Well, we've reached the stage where it's a mere formality at this point. They've got the comfortable lead. We know what the outcome is going to be. I guess the only question is, do they want to put more points on the board before the final gun?
Well, I certainly hope not. And I'm being selfish here because you and I have flights to catch. Let's go ahead and finish this one off, guys. You've taken care of business. Let's close it out. And you and I, let's get to the airport.
Back to Mixon on first down. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. Again, it's Mixon. That's a pretty strong running there as he'll take this across the 50 and down to the 44. There's a fake on the jet sweep and a run up the middle with Mixon. And to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
2 yards to go, second down. Now it's Mixon running right. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Third and two. They'll try and run here with Mostert. And an excellent job of finding the opening as he's got this now all the way down to the 22. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Inside handoff to Mixon. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly.
There's a block in the back.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. So retract the yardage and retract the touchdown.
And retract the chunk play. Big strike there to get the touchdown. Now they've got to take it back and see if they've got another one still in their arsenal.
On second down, Mostert. It's a gain of maybe 3, but it's going to leave them with still about 8 or 9 to go on third down.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Good game, buddy. Good game. Half of my team's fired.
They gave the nation quite a show, putting up that many points.
You need to fire your head coach.
Certainly be a memorable win for them.
And Brandon, I think it's as simple as this. Some players, some teams, they're just meant for the big stage. And when they get a chance to play in this type of
It'd be nice if my guys could catch or hold on to a ball.
All the lights are shining brightly. They show up.
Yeah, that's show out. That's been my problem.
So for Miami, they move back over 500 at 7-6.
Fletcher Cox just retired.
Next week.
Did he?
Meanwhile, for Tennessee, it's unfortunately more of the same as they'll fall to 3-10 on the year. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves.
I wonder what the Chiefs are still going to trade Snead away. When they franchise tagged him, they said they were doing that to trade him away, right? Like, can they afford Jones and fucking Snead both?
Right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
Probably not. I mean, I hate to say it, but I'd rather have Snead than Jones.
Because I heard that's what the Bengals were trying to do with Higgins. Tag him and then try to trade him away.
Yeah. I mean, that's when the Chiefs tagged Snead, that's what I heard they were doing. They tagged him so they could trade him away.
Family, I'm not with other people. They say I got my pops to meet. Everybody's speaking, the garden's still private.
Well, I'm going to get off here. I'll talk to you later.
Yeah, have a good one, buddy.
To the field, from the field right to the show. All my dogs are trained to go. Make sure my people don't work no more. Been